What you're about to see, what we're about to upload in the next couple days, we're going to do back-to-back-to-back Orlando truck meet videos. All of our days spent in Orlando and what we did with the trucks. We are back currently. We're back. Successful trip. Great truck event. So hopefully you like these videos. We do have videos on standby just because of the rush of everything. I haven't had any time to upload. So we have a video with the first gen, building the first gen, storing some B-Lock American Forces that are coming up, and a full airlift kit that we put on the Mega Cab. Those videos are coming. Be patient. I want to show you guys the Orlando truck meet videos first. Get that done out of the way. So enjoy those. Enjoy this video. I will see you after all the mayhem's done. See ya.
Gotta buy my joint up on this bitch. I miss you. Yeah. All my hoes do shrooms, nigga. All my hoes do coke. 20 karat ring, I put my fingers down her throat. If I lose a carrot, she might choke. I know she gon' swallow, she a goat. Free band, nigga, bring the rats in. Got the shooters in the corner, light a pack in. She think cause she's out of bitch, she attractive. That's that shit that get you put up out the section. And the model still the same. Fall like I won a championship game. You know these hoes hungry, they gon' fuck for a name. I put her on the game, she get fucked for a chain. Got your girl in this bitch, she twirling on the dick.
Welcome back to Turn On Diesel, boys. It is time for the biggest show of the year, for us at least. We are going to Orlando, Florida. First time going to the Florida Truck Meet in about 3 years. They held it in Miami. We decided not to go to Miami since it was such a long drive. Miami's just not where it's at. Daytona got too big, so they got kicked out. They went to Miami, signed a contract with Bithlo or some kind of Orlando Speed World in Orlando. So they are hosting it there, and we are going. Just got done building the first gen. First gen is not even a day old build. Like, this thing is fresh off the lot. Mega Cab is up there, completely washed. We got the rims polished up. We got a brand new Diamond C trailer with a winch. Gotta go get the black truck. They got a little bit of color matching done on it, but we'll go pick that up in a second. But first things first, we gotta get the first gen on here, then the black truck.
Trucks are loaded up. We didn't film in the rain, loading up the trucks because it's raining.
We are southbound in the good old Cummins. I'm gonna show you the setup here in a second. Never hauled a load as heavy as this before. Hopefully the Diamond C can keep up with it. And I see the setup right now and it looks insane. We have an issue on the black truck. We accidentally popped a tire on it. I'll get into that a little bit later. That happened 24 hours ago. We already have a tire waiting for us in Florida. Done, paid for, ready to get mounted and balanced. That is awesome. This is gonna be our second haul with the Diamond C. It's downpouring rain, so we're gonna get in the truck, but boys, it's go time.
Young dope, dealer selling dope, is you like that? Kicking doors, kicking in doors, is you like that? Young throw, nigga selling lows, is you like that? All 24, you on go, is you like that? Niggas from the bottom really like that. Stepping in Balenci's if you like that. Pop another bottle if you like that.
These niggas talking out of their neck. Don't put no coughing out of your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for threats. Hey, let's get it, bro. DOT, the money, power, respect. The last one is better. Say yes, a lot of goofies with a check. I mean,
Guys, so we're about 100 and I would say about 150 miles into the trip so far. We got, from the start, we had about a 1,200 mile trip. We're going all the way down to Venice, Florida. That's going to be our first stop on this week-long trip here. Tuesday right now, we're gonna make our way over to Orlando Truck Meet on Friday to get everything around for the truck meet. But until then, we're shooting down to Venice, Florida to see my parents. We do have a connection for the tire that I
stupidly blue on my black truck. Well, I'll go over that with you guys a little bit later. Airbags on the med cab are going good. Skinny tires holding up just fine. And the brand new Diamond C trailer that we picked up is hauling great.
We are doing our second fuel up, actually. The cheapest diesel spot we could find at $3.79 a gallon. Things hauling pretty good. We've been averaging about 75 mile an hour. Say we got about 12 and a half hours left. I go pick up a tire for the black truck. We got one on speed dial. We got a guy in Sarasota, Florida to pick up the tire. Pretty much that stuff.
Up the border is going downhill. They got lights out and everything. I didn't even see a sign for it coming in. Usually they're all over the place. No lights are on or anything. Not like it used to be, I can tell you that. Okay, guys, so we just showed up to the tire place, 38-inch Fury for the black truck since I blew it. I think we're at the right place here.
I'm pretty sure we're at the right place.
We get the truck offloaded or turned around or talk to somebody and pretty much get this whole situation figured out. All right, guys, so it's kind of hard to see, but that's where I cut the tire. I cut it at this trailer thing just sitting here. I accidentally ran up over it, but yeah, she cut her in there pretty good. The truck right there, it's sitting there. Literally just dropped my tire off of the ramp of the truck as soon as we put the mega cab in park. So 20 hour drive, somehow it managed to show up the same time we did. You have to go through the 20 stage process of getting these caps and lug nuts off. Oh, all that road grime, all that solid stuff that came from New York. That's all what that is. You guys live in New York and you're driving a personal vehicle and that's what that is. Good luck with the after effects of that. And that's why we drive Dakotas. Good news is, we got the tire fixed. We're good to go. Bad news is, none of the other tires match it. Whew. That didn't take as long as I thought it was gonna. We're not dressed for Florida. We've been outside for about 10 minutes. It's cloudy. I'm sweating. Good old earthquake. No need for snap on wind. Of course.
Casey. There's you earlier.
Huh? What, the flat tire? Me 10 minutes ago versus me now. Progress, not perfection. We are show ready, kind of. Now this tire looks too good. At least the truck can drive.
Could only afford one.
only afford one. House real big, cars real big, belly real big, everything real big, rims real big, pockets real big, rings real big. Let me tell you how I live. Like that, buy that, 24s ride that. Ladies, gentlemen, gangsters, pimps, mamas, daddies, stunners, shine like a rich snitch. I'm a real big time. King of the hood. Everything wood, look like a forest in the truck and I'm a pull. Masses over set, big open deck. Hardwood flows and that thing that connect from the front to the back. Try to top that, 6'15", beating hard in the deck. Push that button, microwave oven. I'm just getting started, pimp, you ain't seen nothing. That a fish tank, bro, in the middle of the dash. Yeah, pimp, but don't put your fingers on my glass. Got a two-lane bowling alley up in the truck. And on the other side of bed, if she wanna get stuck. Clap off lights when you're getting affection. Clap on lights when you're finding protection. Now where in the wide, wide world of Gator can you find another truck with a plush elevator? House real big, cars real big, belly real big, everything real big. Rims real big, pockets real big, rings real big. Let me tell you how I live. All right, so we gotta be quiet, but we're in like this. Not really a muscle car channel here, so you guys probably might not love this, but regardless, just stopping here for a second. We're going over to the Lambo dealership right now. You guys a little splice over there, but pretty nice cars here. Maybe one day we'll buy a Chevelle SS for the channel, maybe. Alright, so these are our options for the day. We got a good old Cadillac and this thing. I'm gonna go get some breakfast here. T-minus one day until the big old Orlando truck show, so I'll go for the sweatpants in here. We finally have an updated
interior, kind of, even though this thing is extremely small.
Where's the sport mode on this?
I think you press the paddle shifters and it goes into sport mode.
And first stop on our trip, outside of the truck, is Starbucks. We don't usually get Starbucks very often, which is good because I don't really like it. Starbucks, then breakfast.
How's your drink?
All right, so now we are going to unload the truck. We have decided for the day that we're going to make our one vacation day. We are going to base it around vehicles. Big surprise. We are going to unload the black truck, and then we are going over to Lamborghini Sarasota to look at some Lambos for you guys. Maybe some muscle cars later. I don't know. My dad has something all planned that he wants to do, so. So we're at the, gonna unload the black truck. We figured we'd break in the brand new tire a little bit so it doesn't have like the new tire nipples around it. I'll move the neck counter head. That should be good for now. Get the trailer positioned to a point where you can pretty much back the black truck right off. I think there should be enough room, maybe. It's gonna be the first time the black truck touches Florida soil in about 3 years. So this is how I popped the tire on the truck right here. Admittedly, I was in a rush, getting ready for work, whatever. I took into account that one right there. You can see the truck is pretty tight, I guess, like the width of the trailer. Coming right up over here, backing right up over there, and pretty much balancing the tire right on there, slid right down the sidewall, and pretty expensive to stay. I'm gonna take them out right now, and just I might have to spray paint them more if I don't do it.